This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today I'm going to talk about one thing in a Windows machine that you're probably not using enough of. One thing that you probably turned off years ago and disabled, and you're probably just now using it. One thing that in Windows XP made a huge difference in allowing it to protect the operating system from computer worms. And that one thing is the Windows Firewall. Now, if you're as old as I am, you'll probably have at least one war story or maybe more about how the Windows Firewall was either the horrible bane of your existence or something that was your friend. I still remember a technology conference that I was at where the tech floor show people were setting up Windows machines and they hadn't turned on the Windows Firewall. And it happened to be the day that a worm came out on the internet, and here they had all of these machines set up on the web with the firewalls not on, and you can only imagine what happened. You got it. A whole bunch of machines rebooting all at the same time, and people on the staff didn't know what to do with it. Needless to say, it took a whole extra day for the floor staff to put machines back into operation so that they could demonstrate the technology offerings to the attendees. Since Windows XP Service Pack 2, the Windows Firewall has been enabled by default. And how many of us came in here and turned it off because it was too much of a bother? Now in Windows 10 and Server 2019, the vast majority of needed firewall policies are already built into the firewall. When you start a wizard, especially in Server 2019, and you build that rule to install a role, it automatically builds the firewall policy for you. Now, I recommend that when you set up a firewall rule, that you don't set it up by a port, but you actually set it up with the application in mind, so that if the application is on and enabled, it will go out when it needs to. If you open it by port, it keeps that port open at all times. So remember, build a rule by application, not by port. Next, I always recommend that you go into the properties of the firewall and you go into settings and customize, and you make sure that the display and notification is enabled when a program is blocked from receiving inbound connections. This will help you in setting up your firewall rules. You can also look for event 5031, the Windows Firewall service blocked an application from accepting incoming connections. And this will tell you the application and what profile it's trying to go out on. Here's another recommendation. You can use the firewall to restrict PowerShell of going out to the internet. Now, why is this a good thing? Attackers use PowerShell these days to pull information from the web. So if you block PowerShell from going outside of your local domain, it means you can protect your network better. So run this command that allows you to protect from multiple PowerShell binaries. And once you run it, it'll say OK. And you'll notice once you go into the firewall rules, you'll notice that you have the PS allow LAN and PS deny all, the two rules that were set up using that command. Finally, I always recommend that when reviewing the security status of your network, that you take a random sample of workstations on a regular basis and audit the settings in the machine. Review the firewall policies on each sample workstation. I'm often surprised about applications that have built rules for themselves if I've forgotten to build a blocking rule. Take the time to use and understand how powerful the Windows Firewall can be in your organization. Until next time, don't forget, check out for more on IDG Tech Talk out on YouTube. This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.